Hey everyone, thank you so much for checking out this YouTube channel. It's going to be called Lucky Star Woodcrafts. I hope you enjoy the video I'm about to show you. Please subscribe if you get a chance to, and have a good day. So after I got done breaking down the plywood, I cut out a 3/4 inch groove to fit the back of the panel of the hexagon dresser. I don't have a dado blade, so it took me a while to cut the groove, but if you can use a dado blade, then go for it. If you have a router, that works as well. The depth of the cut was about 1/2 inch. As you can tell, I'm just here cutting it, making sure my lines were straight. Nothing too fancy, using the slide to help me cut straight. So here you can see I'm just cleaning up the groove that I cut, and make sure to clamp down your piece of wood. Because if you don't, then it will for sure move on you, and then you won't get a really good clean surface, I guess. But yeah, I pretty much just sand down the groove I cut, make sure everything was smooth, and had to do that to all 6 sides. Oh, also, make sure you wear like some sort of mask to kind of filter out the dust. It's not very healthy to breathe in, so just, you know, wear some sort of mask. That part out. So right here you can see I then turn my blade to a 30 degree angle on the table saw just to show you the degree on it. I think it goes all the way to like 45, I can't remember. But anyway, I turn my blade to a 30 degree angle and then cut all my sides. Make sure it's a longer side to 30 degree, and I'm making sure all my cuts are straight as possible. You do not want a cut that's not too straight, because then later down the road you will have problems. That happened to me, so I had to remake a couple of things. Also, make sure to just wear a mask if you can. It just kind of helps you not to breathe in as much wood dust as possible. So right here, after I got done cutting all the sides, it's pretty much time to put it all together. I use wood glue and ratchet strap. Right here you could see that I'm just putting the wood glue on the side. I don't have like a little brush I could put on, so I just use like a scrap wood and just kind of lay it down there. And then do that to all the sides besides the top and bottom side, because you're not gluing anything. So just do that. So right here, I'm pretty much using the ratchet strap to wrap around. Make sure you protect the corner with some sort of like soft material, or it doesn't matter. Just protect the corner of it so it doesn't get dented in, and then it doesn't look very good. So I just put a piece of wood, and you can have use some cardboard, which I use cardboard right here. Do it both sides. So right here, I pretty much take all the ratchet strap off, and just check over, make sure all the edges are smooth and clean. then I use a chisel to remove. Make sure you clamp down project. I use a chisel to remove all the little like dried up glue knot or whatever it is. Just kind of clean that up. Sand it if you need to. I just use a chisel because it was easier for me. That's it, really. For the next part, I just went through and make sure to cut all my edge flat. So I just kind of cleaned it up. Everything, you want to make sure it's all lined up perfectly. If you don't, you will have problems down the road. Like I said in the beginning, make sure everything is pretty straight and flat. So for this part, I know just by gluing the edge probably won't really hold the hexagon together. It won't be strong enough if you put stuff in there. So I went ahead and pretty much made a jig that was about 30 degree angle hole, and then just drilled that all the way through. Right here you can see that I clamped that jig onto the hexagon. And then I just drill a 30 degree angle hole and then just went right through it. And then that way in the future you could put a dowel rod in, which will help you make it more secure. The dowel rod, I think, was about like, oh man, I think it was like a quarter of an inch. You could probably go bigger than that. Pretty much cut about two inches of dowel rod, and I cut a lot of them. I think I was cutting 36 2-inch dowel rod because I was making three of them, and each of them has about 12. So then I glue that, and then I pretty much put them in the hole I just drilled. So right here, I was just making sure to clamp down my work because that way it won't move whenever I'm working on it. So So what I'm preparing to do is pretty much cut out the dowel rod that's been glued to the corner. I just use a Japanese pull saw, which would pretty much cut a flush. It would be like a flush cut. As you can see, I'm preparing to cut it. When you cut, please make sure to go slow. As you can see, I'm not really going too slow there, but just make sure you're going slow enough to where you're not damaging the material. Don't go too fast because you will damage it, but also don't go too slow because it might take forever. So right here, I'm just cutting the face of the dresser. What I did was I pretty much turned the dresser, lay it on a flat sheet of plywood, the face, and then I traced the line outside. Make sure the line is outside, not inside. And then I just took that, break it down to a smaller piece, and then I took that to and put it on my table saw, and then just cut the shape out using the line as my guide. The shape is a little tricky, so just take your time on it. So right here, I'm not going to show you how to put a drawer slide, but this is the part where I just put the drawer slides in. It's pretty easy. All you have to do is put the drawers on the side that you want, and then line it up on one edge, and then make holes, put it in there, and that's it really. If you don't know how to put a drawer slide in, you could probably just YouTube how to put a drawer slide in, and then there's probably a bunch of videos to show you how to do it. But here is just like, I'm showing the very basic, and very little bit of what I filmed pretty much. Right here is where I'm putting that back panel in, and it fit pretty well. I was actually quite happy with it. As you can see, there is a little gap here and there, but not bad though. Consider first try. Right here, I'm just hammering down, make sure everything is tight. And I think I went a little bit over the hammer, but I put glue in the groove that I just cut out, and then I pretty much put that in. No nails, nothing holding it. And then right here, I'm just going back and forth to make sure everything is sanded correctly. And please excuse my dog; they just wanted to be with me, so I took them to the shop. Now, I also did not film myself sanding. I'm pretty sure you don't want to see that anyway. It just, I went from 120 all the grit to 220 grit from the top surface. That's what I did, is all the way to 220. And then inside, I didn't really sand it because nobody's really going to touch the inside. So no worry on that. So right here, I'm pretty much actually just using a sticky paper. I can't remember what's it called. and it just takes all the wood dust on there and just kind of clear all that up. So whenever I apply finish, it'll actually stick on there. And then here is where I'm actually applying the finish using Danish oil. I just want something that's easy, nothing fancy. I want a natural color as well, so Danish oil works perfectly fine. It will take a little while for you to apply Danish oil on there, but once you're done, you could give it two or three coat. I think I did two coats on the outside where the most surface is being touched. Inside, I just did one because not you won't be touching too many surface inside. And if you want, you could also cover the sliders, but I didn't think it was that big of a deal. They'll be all right. For the legs, they're like 6 inches legs, and then I just bought them off Amazon. They're metal legs. They're 6 inches tall. They works perfectly fine. For the gluing on the side, how I connect them as a pre connect the three cells together, it was pretty much gluing and screws. I put wood glue, clamp it down, and then after that, I use screws and I put the screws. I hid them inside the sliders, so a longer screw to connect both of them together. And that's it, pretty much. I hope you guys enjoyed the video, and please subscribe if you want, and thank you.